It's not what you think, okay? It's not what you think. Okay, so what if I become a little bit of a weeaboo? Just a little bit, I swear. I've barely even watched over, like, 5 anime. Which is why today I'm bringing you guys my top 5 animes, because I barely watched over 5. Digimon. Why is Digimon on this list? Well, for the sole purpose of that I couldn't find any other good anime. Although, okay, let's get real here. Digimon is a great anime. Maybe it's a ripoff of Pokemon? Yeah, it is. But like, honestly, it's such a great experience. The first 2 seasons exclusively, by the way. The other 4 seasons can go throw themselves off of my Nintendo Switch right here.
Here are the other seasons. And then, wah.
So that's the other seasons of Digimon, but the first 2 seasons are really great. They encompass a lot of friendship and stuff like that, so it's an experience that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Also, I found a lot of the Digimon pretty cool, actually. I wish there were Pokemon like that. One time when I was like 5, I did a black and white Let's Play. So it's the big granddaddy of them all, isn't it? Soul Eater is number 4. I really like Soul Eater. The characters are great. The Halloween aesthetic is fine, I guess. I don't really care about that, but I love the characters. They're all, like, expanded upon or exaggerated from their own personality traits. But that's fine, because it's this show. This show is so exaggerated, with the Grim Reaper literally being a dancing black blob with a white face. The only character I wish they developed upon a tiny bit more is the main character, Maka. That's because she doesn't really have any character traits besides being, brave. Can you expand more upon that? The only other thing I remember about Maka is that she can cook, and that's from this one exchange between her and Soul from, like, I don't know what episode. Also, Soul Eater has, like, some of the most killer OPs. Like, dude. I love them in different sort of senses, right? OP1 Resonance is so cool and like swanky, and it like, you know, introduces us to all the characters in some kind of like dancing fashion, I guess. But OP2 Papermoon is like all hope is lost and evil has taken over the world. But you know that's not gonna happen because it's an anime and good always has to win. Cause good always does win. Yes, it's that good, and boy, do I love Pokemon. It's the first anime I've watched. It's probably the first anime you guys watch that can be considered an anime, since it's Japanese art-created, and it's the one that I don't know. I just have no words for it. I love it. Okay, not every season is made particularly in the same light as the others. The season I watched most was Black and White, like that whole region, those 3 seasons, and it's one of their weakest, I'm not gonna lie. But all the seasons are at least very incredibly passable. And X and Y and Diamond or Pearl are some of my favorite seasons of anime just in general. They're great. I love Pokemon. The new Alola series, it's cool and all, but I mean, I know they're trying to change up the formula with everything, and Alola, and no gym badges, and stuff and stuff like that, but I like the old formula. I don't really look at Pokemon for, like, slice of life content like that, so, yeah, Alola's fine, I guess. I'm excited for Sword and Shield, though. You guys excited for no national decks? Anyways, I know Pokemon started as a video game series, but the anime is pretty cool too, and it's the first anime I've watched that I have special place for it in my heart, and this spot won't be taken until a better anime gets made.
Number 2 is Death Note. And for obvious reasons,
I'm recording this in my closet. Now, Death Note is so incredibly great, guys. I love it so much. I'm so glad that I watched it before I watched SAO. It's got such great characters, such great plot development. I love the story, its originality. I know that's hard for anime these days, but I'm surprised Death Note got to do it with this sort of cat and mouse chase game between L and Light. So it's overall a great ethereal experience that I'd totally rewatch again right now if I wasn't watching every single other anime on the planet. I really love everything about it. The score is great, sometimes with great choral choir singing, and other times with, like, you know, just, I don't know, Vsauce music before Vsauce music was a thing. I like the theme of justice, with everyone's different senses of justice coming into fruition, all different opportunities for you to see other people's views of justice. And while I don't totally agree with either side, L or Light, I can agree that there's some truth to both of them. And I think that's the aim with Death Note, is for it to help you find your own sense of justice and show you other people's perspectives on it. And honestly, with that, I think Death Note is the best anime on this list. So why isn't it number one? One Punch Man. Oh my gosh, do I love One Punch Man. I honestly haven't been more in love with a show than, like, I don't know, The Office. And I mean, like, honestly, what's not to love? The characters are great, the story is, well, awesome, and it's the number one story from an anime, or at least superhero anime that I've seen. Oh, and it's a superhero anime, but it's a parody on superheroes. It's great. And our main protagonist, by the way, Saitama, is the most overpowered person ever. And I just love him for that, because that is an awesome trait. But I like the sense of boredom that he gives us with all this power that he has, how lonely he is being the strongest man. And I don't know, it's a different perspective from all the superhero animes we've seen, of, like, you know, people, like, becoming stronger and finding someone to finally, you know, But with Saitama, it's just like, ah, come on. I defeated this guy with one punch again. And every time you're just like, dude, you killed him in one punch. And he's just like, but I'm bored. And so it's incredible. I don't think it's the best anime. I mean, especially considering season 2. I haven't watched season 2. Full disclaimer, I haven't watched it. It's only on Hulu. My only source of anime is on Netflix. Don't judge me, but I still love it, right? It's incredible. Season 2 looks, worse animation and art style than season 1, in my opinion. OP is it's definitely worse. It's good, but season 1 is one of the greatest seasons of anime I've watched, but of course there are, like, some issues. I still see Death Note as a better anime with more character development, better story, and, like, more epic, ethereal experiences. One Punch Man, to me, is just so much cooler, and, like, it's more awesome, and I love seeing Saitama beat everything with one punch with, like, the greatest animation. Oh, and also my favorite anime OP of all time. The Hero by Jam Project is an incredible OP, and if you're new to, like, OPs in general, besides, like, the Pokemon theme, since everyone's heard that, that's definitely the first one you should listen to, because it gets you so hyped for the show. I love it. And with that, I conclude my favorite, the top 5 animes
currently in July of 2019.